And as Pastor Sylvester comes in, we welcome him and the brethren who are here today. We welcome you in the mighty name of Jesus. And we pull the glory and appeal to the right to the gift of the Lord unto now. Praise his name. Praise his wonderful name. Praise his name.
From the Lord. Thank you very much. You may be seated in the presence of Praise the Lord. We are still on rescue and restoration. Praise the Lord. Praise His name. I took some time last night to look into the lesson and into the book of Hosea. And all I can say to myself, what a mess. Praise the Lord. Come to the church of God. What a mess. Amen. Praise the Lord. Can you imagine the man of God? God commanded him to go and to take up a war. A promiscuous man. Somebody who sleep around with all the kind of men. Can you imagine that? Divine command from the Lord. Probably if God tells me to do it, I'll refuse. And none of us want to take up a war. Amen. But God is giving you what? Rescue and restoration.
Free and limitless, the gift that keeps on giving. When we presume upon grace like this, we grieve God and show our ingratitude. When we show His giver, when we should be His giver, we become takers. Then this is what Isaiah 1 verse 3 is all about. The book begins with God's shocking command for the prophet Isaiah to marry a whore and have children with her. Isaiah obeys God and marries Gomer. They have three children, a boy, Jezreel, a girl, bless the Lord, Mark, and another boy, Lora. But Gom is a promiscuous, unfaithful wife. She takes what didn't Father Isaiah give her love. And she doesn't hear that she's hurting him. Merely to indulge herself. That's chapter 1.
Isaiah's marriage is an inactive prophecy about God's marriage to Israel and what is to come. He loves her, but she's been unfaithful. She has betrayed his love and chased after other gods both again and again. The names of Isaiah's three children speak to the pitiful state of God's relationship with Israel and his judgment. Given the violence, not the relationship, there seems no hope of repairing the brokenness once said, but the worst. Relationship is good. Against all expectations, there is hope, not because of Israel's goodness, but because of God's faithfulness. He has not given up their relationship.
Quite sure there's a few comments based on the age of Elisha Bishop and Campbell.
Praise
his name.
Praise his name.
another thing that I want to add to it is that the Lord, He is when we have other gods. He is greater abomination.
Amen.
Something that the Lord is. You know, if you turn the Bible from back to front, He is always speaking against that thing. That great abomination, when you turn from God and you start to visit other gods, and you start to do other gods, to do your whatever you want, to be done. And you use it in your own manner, even against the people of God. But God is calling us today, because He loved us, He wants us to turn away from our wicked ways and come back to Him. Praise the Lord.
Praise His name.
Thank you,
Sister Davis. Bishop has
praise the Lord,
praise the Lord,
praise the Lord,
praise the Lord.
We are in a pleasant story. And we have a set program for a day. Different speakers and activities for the day. But this lesson to me today is a very serious lesson. And to me, it's a judgment decision with this lesson. I did not really study the lesson at the moment. But I studied enough so far that if I didn't even scan the lesson today, then I still can defend myself. For if you study the word enough, only you refresh your brain at the time. Might be we will have to transport this lesson another time, because it is very deep and it is very hard. And I don't know what to say. Because, for instance, God said in the book that was around me, "Thou art a holy people unto the very Israel," chapter 6. Thou art a holy people unto the Lord thy God. The Lord thy God hath chosen thee to be our special people above all other people upon the face of the earth.
Oh yes.
As God's chosen people. What we're doing here. God, if you should tell somebody today that we are chosen people above everybody, they will believe that you're trying to denounce other people. But the word says, thou art a holy people. Lord, I God has chosen me to be a special people above all the people of the enemies of the earth. Now, the word does not contradict itself. God also warned Israel, his people. And that's do not marry another set of people. Because they are idol worshippers. So don't allow your daughters to marry to their son. Don't allow their son to marry to your daughters. Because if they come in Israel, they are going to bring them the custom. So God told them, don't mix with them. years ago.
We
because so I'm not good with the food.
So what's your word?
Huh? It's not even just that in the church we have times that you might be in the church. And you are in the church and you are like this of a keeper, of a commanding shepherd, and you might be used to somebody that you would love both sides of here that may not be as not a keeper. Oh, commanding shepherd. And you would bring them over into the field. Bring them over into the field. And you might that may be provided not to bring them over that soul. But we know so much about how to read the word and my revenge. That is, I believe, let this lesson, don't take it sad, but let this lesson be an example to us today. That when we turn away from righteousness and doing the opposite way, we're classed as a dog. They're going to be right with you. You're more than happy to have it. this brother lives together with the pastor, and we are going to see it. And when I went into great, when I really this young lady, he was say, why? This is a funny man. Him so low, everything's at one time. Him have some Jewish here, and then they get so long they are there, so eventually they want to get them clean, and they get them clean, and they take them back right there. You see, in just at least one line, in just man, what it happened. Okay? Here you are, but you wash in the yard. Take care of your house, but you wash in the house.
So,
and some young men, some kids, when we get in some diet, some big pants, when we come in attitude, we have some things where we like to eat, but it's not right. And we can't we love eating, and we're not right, but because it is a God that we have, we send our blessings. Let let not the desire of the wicked come to pass. The desire of the wicked. The desire of the wicked come to pass. And sometimes, Father, come and do we show on the evil. I wish him if he had dead not trying. I don't wish him for the first. That's a evil heart. That's a evil heart. You have to watch your heart. You know what? You have to have a watch. Amen. Sometimes God bless somebody. How is the person? I'm coming in that God. Where he might be. He might come out. Sometimes with COVID. Yes. COVID, you say, no, don't hear God say. Sometimes with COVID, we're very near God. Yes. Now, that's the first thing. You COVID, my people are coming out, pray. I pray, I want to pray. He turned into the balance, when he pray. So, this is the time. Is there one in my God, I ain't gonna know you, see, pray.
Thank you.